Hi, Matt here from NotchTherapy.com. We're going to be installing Audacity in this video. So a very short video, 5 minutes or so, on how to install Audacity for your platform. If you're not technical, you just need to follow some instructions. It's no big deal. So here we're going to go. Audacity is an audio processing program that's very robust and feature-rich. Fortunately, for our purposes, it's also dead simple to use. We don't need to get into anything particularly advanced at all. So I'm going to type in Audacity download. That's, notice the spelling. Google's already returned, as it normally does. It's already returned some results for me. Audacity, that's what the logo looks like. Here are the download links for Windows and Mac. It also works on Linux if you're so inclined. I'm going to click on the Mac link. Actually, I'm going to click on the Windows. I'm a Mac user. I've already got it installed, though. For Windows folks, notice that it's just a Windows installer, and it's just a very straightforward thing. It sort of supports all of the versions that you would expect, as well as on the Mac. Linux has instructions as well, obviously. So I do want to call something out, and this is quite important, actually. So get Audacity installed, sort of step one, all right? Now, step two is keep this page up. Don't close your browser out. Keep this page up. After Audacity is installed, I need you to come back and click on this plugins link, plugins. And you'll see, I might need to move my window around. It's coming back a little slowly, but yeah, you're gonna see, okay, here we go. Nyquist plugins, that one. That's what we want, Nyquist plugins. I'm gonna scroll over. You'll see a link here for the Nyquist plugins. There you go. So click that link for Nyquist plugins. And it should take me to that. Here we go. So I'm gonna go to the complete list of Nyquist plugins. Okay, now I'm at the Nyquist plugins page. And if you scroll down to section 5, filters, the very first one is band stop filter. That's our guy. So we're going to install that guy. We're just simply going to download it. You click on the link and then you click on download. And I'll show you how to do that here in a second. But before I do, notice that there's installation instructions here in this section. Read that for your platform. If it's in Windows, you simply move the file that you download into this folder. Just drag and drop it. Same idea on Mac as well. And on Linux, you simply move it into the appropriate directory. Okay, so we're going to go now back to our band stop filter. I'm going to click on this. And then I would simply just download it, and then drop that file as it is. Just drag it and drop it. You don't need to click an installer. There's no menus. It's just you grab that file and drag it and drop it into the Audacity application folder that it tells you to on the installation instructions, and then that's it. Here's what it looks like now that we've done this. Congratulations. Here's what it looks like. I've got Audacity open here. I think I do, at least. Let me go, yes, I do, new file. So here's what Audacity looks like, and I'll resize it so you can see. So that's what Audacity looks like. And now I'm going to go to, on the top menu, I'm going to go to Effect. And you should see band stop filter there. It's grayed out for me, but you can see because I don't have any audio to process. That's why it's grayed out. I'm going to go ahead and generate some white noise. I'm going to click on the Generate menu. I'm going to do an entire video dedicated to this. And I'm going to generate some white noise. And here I've generated some white noise just like... That's what it sounds like. I know it sounds terrible on my little speakers on my laptop. So now I'm going to grab, and then I'll go to Effect, and I'll grab Band Stop Filter. Click on that. You should see Band Stop Filter in your effects menu. If you do not, something is not working, and you need to sort of review your steps. And here is the Band Stop Filter. I'm going to go into much, much more detail on how to use this beast, as well as potentially a notch filter if anybody out there feels like that's necessary. I don't know that it is, but anyways, and that's this using the band stop filter after we've found our frequency is going to be in the next video. So stay tuned, and thanks for tuning in. And here's two quieter times with your tinnitus. Talk to you soon.